All right, so in order to determine the sign of torque, so either positive or negative, all we have to do is look at each torque separately. So if we're given more than one torque, for example, on the right-hand side here, I have a diagram, which I'll explain in a moment, that has multiple forces acting on it, so it will have multiple torques. We're just going to look at each one separately, as if that was the only force being applied. And ask yourself, what direction would this force cause the system to rotate in if it were the only force? And so once again, as a reminder, we defined universally clockwise motion, or motion that goes like this, right, in the direction of a clock. We define that to be negative. And we defined counterclockwise motion, or motion that goes in the opposite direction of a clock, so like that. We define that to be positive. Make that bigger. All right, so based on that, we're going to look at each of these forces on the right-hand side here. And what this is a pin joint. And so a pin joint is nothing more than a joint where, let's just say there's like a nail or something, you know, keeping this system in place. And there's a metal rod that is attached to the pin joint, and it's allowed to rotate about the joint. So it can rotate freely up and down or left and right, depending on how you look at this. And then now we're applying two forces. So imagine that this is just like a door, right? We're pushing on a door in one direction, that's force of A, and then we're pushing on a door in another direction. And I'm going to ask the question, like for example, for force A right here, force A produces a torque. If I wanted to calculate that torque, I could just find the distance between, let's say this is right, the hinge from here to here. That would be my R, my lever arm. And this force is completely perpendicular, so that would just be, you know, this force multiplied by R. Is that going to be positive or negative? Well, if I ignore force B right now and just ask myself the question, if I just push on the door like this, right, which way is it going to rotate? Well, if you said it's going to rotate like this, right, in this direction, I'd agree with you. And we know that that is going to be the counter, this is counter clockwise because it's against the clock direction. And so that's going to be positive. So the torque produced by force A is going to be positive, because if that were the only force, it would cause the door to rotate in the counterclockwise direction. Simple as that. Now, if we look at force B alone, just by itself, I'm going to totally forget about force A right now. What direction would force B cause this door, if you will, to rotate in? Well, it would cause the door to start rotating that way. And what is that direction? Well, that's clockwise. So that would be a negative direction. Therefore, the torque produced by force B, torque B, is going to be negative, because that force producing torque would cause the system to rotate in the clockwise or negative direction. So all you have to do to decide the direction of torque is to figure out which direction it would cause the system to rotate in if it were the only torque, and then remember that clockwise is negative and counterclockwise is positive. If you've got a hard time remembering those two things, I like to think about, and typically in math, right, we start at 0 degrees and then go to 90 and then 180, and then, you know, this would be 270, and then all the way back here to 360. So we typically think of, you know, our quadrant, 1, 2, 3, and 4, we typically go in a counter, this is counterclockwise, right? And that's typically positive in math. So if you think about it from a math standpoint, you've been making counterclockwise positive probably your whole life. So I'd just like you to remember that if it's hard to remember clockwise and counterclockwise. And remember, the system doesn't actually need to be rotating. The system could be in equilibrium or at rest. It's just what direction it would cause it to move in if that torque were to cause rotation, for example. So it doesn't actually have to be moving. We can just think about what direction it would cause it to rotate in if it were powerful enough. All right, let's put this all together and look at an example problem of calculating torques.